Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Study of Science in a Simple Way. Today I will discuss about the suspension and flow. In the previous lecture we will discuss about the what is the concentration of a solution. Now today I will discuss about the suspension. Before starting my lecture, please subscribe my channel, please like this video and share this video. So let's start what is the suspension. Actually, on the basis of size of solute particles, solution can be divided into three categories: true solution, colloidal solution, and third one is the suspension. On the basis of size of solute particle, solution can be divided into three categories. First one, that is true solution. Second, that is colloidal. And third one is the suspension. We shall discuss about the true solution the previous lecture. But now we will discuss about the suspension. Then after this video, I will make that video about the colloidal solution. Now the time for the suspension. What is the suspension and how we can determine this solution is suspension solution. Okay, let's start. Suspension. Suspension is a heterogeneous solution. We discussed that is the mixture is of two types, homogeneous mixture, heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture are those mixture which have uniform properties, means everywhere having same properties. But the heterogeneous mixture have different properties, and that type of mixture is said to be heterogeneous mixture. Means in case of suspension, there is a different properties in different places. So, suspension, it is a heterogeneous mixture. It is a heterogeneous mixture. This is very important point, because sometimes students may confuse that maybe homogeneous or heterogeneous. You know, if this is clear, that this is the heterogeneous mixture. It is a heterogeneous mixture in which the solute particle not dissolve in medium, but it suspended in a bulk suspension. Number one, it is a heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture means they have non-uniform properties. Now the second properties of the suspension is that solute particles can be seen by our naked eye. Because the size of particle is greater than 100 nanometer. Third property is, if light pass from this solution, then scattering of light takes place. And you know, this property of solution is said to be Tyndall effect, because this agent discovered by Tyndall. When a beam of light, when a light passes through the suspension solution, then the path of that light is scattered. When light passes from this solution, then the scatter of light takes place. This property is said to be Tyndall effect. Now the fourth property of suspension is that it is unstable solution. Unstable solution means when we kept the suspension solution left undisturbed, then the solute particles are settled down after some time. As you know, when we dissolve the sand particles in water, after some time the sand particle becomes settled down. And this property is said to be unstable solution. Means unstable solution means when the suspension solution is kept undisturbed, after some time the solute particle becomes settled down. This property is said to be unstable solution. Now the examples of suspension. Example number one, chalk powder. Chalk powder in water. This is the examples of suspension. Second, mud in water. Now the third, sand in water. So these are the basic information about the suspension. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel and like this video, and please press the bell notification, please the bell icon for the new video notification. Thank you. Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, Study of Science in a Simple Way. Today I will discuss about the suspension, and in the previous lecture we will discuss about the what is the concentration of the solution. Now today I will discuss about the suspension. Before starting my lecture, please subscribe my channel, please like this video and share this video. So let's start. What is the suspension? Actually, on the basis of size of solute particles, solution can be divided into three categories: true solution, colloidal solution, and third one is the suspension. On the basis of size of solute particle, solution can be divided into three categories. First one, that is true solution. Second, that is colloidal. And third one is the suspension. Yes, I have discussed about the truth solution in the previous lecture, but now we will discuss about the suspension. Then after this video, I will make that video about the collider solution. Now the time for the suspension. What is the suspension and how we can determine the this solution is suspension solution. Okay, let's start. Suspension. Suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. We discussed that in the mixture is of two types: homogeneous mixture, heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture are those mixture which have uniform properties, means everywhere having same properties. But the heterogeneous mixture have different properties, and that type of mixture is said to be heterogeneous mixture. Means in case of suspension, there is a different properties in different places. So suspension, it is a heterogeneous mixture. It is a heterogeneous mixture. This is a very important point, because sometimes the student may confuse that maybe homogeneous or heterogeneous. You know, if this is clear, that this is the heterogeneous mixture. It is a heterogeneous mixture in which the solute particle not dissolve in medium, but it suspended in a means they have non-uniform properties. Now the second properties of the suspension is that solute particles can be seen by our naked eye. Because the size of particles is greater than 100 nanometer. Third property is, if light pass from this solution, then scattering of light takes place. And you know, this property of solution is said to be Tyndall effect, because this is discovered by Tyndall. When a beam of light, uh, when When light passes from this solution, then the scatter of light takes place. This property is said to be Tyndall effect. Now the fourth property of suspension is that it is unstable solution. Unstable solution means when we kept the suspension solution left undisturbed, then the solute particles are settled down after some time. As you know, when you dissolve the sand particles in water, after some time the sand particle becomes settled down. And this property is said to be unstable solution. Means unstable solution means when the suspension solution is kept undisturbed, after some time the solute particle becomes settled down. This property is said to be unstable solution. Now the examples of suspension. Example. Number one, chalk powder. Chalk powder in water. This is the examples of suspension. Second, mud in water. Now the third, sand in water. So these are the basic information about the suspension. So thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel and like this video. And please press the bell notification. Please the bell icon for the new video notification. Thank you.